Hello friends, welcome back. My name is Sushil Singh and this is continuation of SQL Server interview questions and answers. So today I am going to discuss one more question which is related to interviews. In this session, I am going to discuss how we can add only integer values from any string when values are in more than one digit. So in our previous session, I have discussed how we can add values when integer values in our single digit. But in this session, we will understand how we can add the values when they are exist in more than one digit. So let's move to another slide where we will understand what it means. So this is our slide. So here you can see we have an input string and we have an output. In our input string, you can see you will start from left hand side. So our first numeric value would be 1, and then our another numeric value is 3. When we move from left to right, then you will get 4 and then 2. So 4 and 2 are coming together. So when we are going to concatenate between 4 and 2, then we will get 42. And this 42 is a numeric, so it will treat it as a single unit. Then again we are going to move, and here you can see we are going to see 181. When we are going to combine these three values, it will 181. So it will treat it as a single unit. And then 9, and at last you will get 10. So this is our input string. When we are going to add numeric values from our input string, then you will get 246 as in output. So how we can achieve in SQL Server? So let's move to SQL Server Management Studio where we will understand how we can achieve this. So I have already typed the code, so you will understand very easily and we can save the time. So I have declared 5 variables. Our first variable as an input variable, which is var1. So this is our var1 variable and this is our input string. So I have initialized our input string in our @ var1 variable, and then length variable. In length1 variable, I am going to calculate the length of this our input string. So this will be initialized in our length1 variable. So now I am going to use a loop. So here, this loop will be executed until unless the value of this @length1 variable is greater than 0. So inside this loop, I am going to fetch the value from left hand side of this input variable. So this input variable has @ our left hand side. So first value will be picked from here and this value will be initialized in our @t variable. So this value will be initialized in @t variable. Then again, we are going to check inside this loop if this value is numeric or not. When this @t variable value is numeric, then it will move inside this if block, otherwise it will move in else block. So in this condition, it will move in else block. So inside this else block, we have set the value of this final variable is equals to @final, and then I am going to add the value of this @inter variable. By default, it's blank. When we are going to convert in our integer, then it will return 0 because there is no value exist in @inter variable. And then again I am going to initialize this value by blank. So this else block will be finished here, and when this else block will be finished, I am going to use this @var1, and I am going to remove over this left hand side first variable, and then again initialize this value in our @var1 variable. So in var1 variable, I am going to remove the first value from left hand side because I have used this @ in our first execution. For another variable is @length1 variable, I am going to decrease the value by 1. So for next time, it will pick the value because our first @ has been finished, and then it will move our second @. So it will again go to our else block. When this else block will be executed as a same, and final value will be same for our second time. So when these two value will be skipped, then it will move over third character is 1, and it will be executed as the numeric. So for third time, it will insert in our inter variable. So in inter variable, @t will be concatenate with @inter variable. So @inter variable is blank for our first time, and this is 1, so this is 1. So this else block will be skipped and then move to our next. So here it will, one will be skipped and then move to add this hash symbol. So this hash symbol will be picked for fourth time, and once it will be picked, then it will be checked whether this hash is numeric or not. So we know this value is not numeric, so move to our else block. So inside this else block, address final has 0 at this time, so address final value will be 0, and I am going to use this inter variable. So inter variable value is 1, as I have discussed. So we can convert in our integer and we can simply add with address final, and then I am going to set this inter variable as a blank. Execution will be finished. When it will move to 4, then it will be checked and initialize 4 in our inter variable, and then we will move to 2, then it will again fetch the value for 2 and it will be is numeric is true. So it will be concatenate between 4 and 2, so it will be initialize 42 in our inter variable, and then equals to, then if this condition will not be satisfied, then it will move to else block. So inside this else block we can see address final 1 is equals to address final 1 plus I am going to add this inter variable value with this final, so it will be added. So it will be executed for all the execution and we will get the result. So once we will execute it, we can see we are going to get value of 236, but in our slide we can see we want 246 when we are going to add these all these values. So why this happened? Because this integer value is exist at the last position, so we don't have any non-character value after the this integer value. So how we can remove this condition in our code? We have already typed the query, so I'm going to uncomment this code. So here for the last execution I am going to check whether this inter variable value is numeric or not. Once this value will be found as a numeric, then I am going to add this inter variable value in our final and we will get the final value. So it will be checked for last condition as well. So now we can execute and we can see we will get the appropriate result as we want. So here you can see 246 and in our code we have achieved 246. So I hope you have understand how we can achieve this output by using SQL Server. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel for many more videos. If you need this script, it will be available on my Facebook page. You can copy from there. Thank you so much for watching.